Okay, so Kyle, how does it feel that you were made part of this new show?
I feel very blessed, like, to be part of a new show with, like, new talents, and lahat sila, they're all, you know, equally talented, so it's very flattering, actually. So.
And kasi gusto mo performing talagang ano mo, no? Gusto mo, passion mo, and how does it feel na this will give you the chance to do that? Singing, dancing, music?
To be honest, it's just really fun. It doesn't seem like work. It seems like, you know, we're on stage and we're doing what we love. So it's just another outlet to showcase what we do.
Did you dance ba? Or
konti, pero hindi masyado.
How do you find it, the rehearsal? Nahihirapan ba? Or
yeah, minsan I'll find it really hard. Pero if I practice, I could get some dance. But I'm not a dancer, so.
So would you say na mas prefer mo kung singing?
Singing, definitely.
Mga anong pieces bang gusto makakanta mo dito, mga what kind of songs?
R&B, mostly love songs. I'm usually into R&B, but here we, for example, we're singing "Lucky" and "Teenage Dream" by Katy Perry. So those are a couple that we've practiced already.
Kasi I saw your music up late with your band na-baptize niya as
3 a.m.
Ano nang mga ginagawa niyo ngayon as a band?
We're releasing our album soon. Probably next month or beginning of next year under Star Records. It's completely done. They're just putting, you know, all the finishing touches.
Do you write songs, man?
I write, but I haven't really composed any songs yet. Mika, our lead singer, is usually the one who composes all the songs. I actually have 4 originals that are written by him on the album coming up.
Anong genre ng album?
Rock alternative.
Kung i-compare, mala ano ba? Mala heavy rock ba or
di masyado heavy, parang switch
alternative.
Switch foot. Na konti pero more switch foot.
You grew up in
LA? Yes.
Kailan ka dumating dito?
Last July of a year and a half ago.
You came here originally. What was the plan when you arrived here?
I was actually discovered by Erickson Raimundo.
He's Sam Milby.
Yeah, Sam Milby's manager. Before I wasn't part of 3AM, I was solo under Eric. And he wanted me to model and try singing here. And I was discovered in back in the States through Facebook and YouTube. And I finally met him under the Heartthrobs tour. They were traveling
going around.
Yeah. So I got to meet Sam and Violo and Popong and all of them.
Wait, is showbiz a childhood dream or parang nangyari na lang?
It was, I'm an artist. I draw, I'm a graphic designer. That's what my job was actually in the States. But my secret dream was always to, you know, model and sing. So when the opportunity came, I was like, of course I'm gonna try. Kasi it's always been like, what if I could do this? And then all of a sudden, Erickson found me, so.
In your family ba meron ng ibang artist or parang
brother ko?
Anong ginagawa niya?
He's a guitarist.
And
he,
music.
Yeah, he used to be in a lot of bands in the States, and he's very musically inclined. And yeah, just us, kaming dalawa.
Did you have to ask your parents' permission to pursue showbiz here, or okay naman talaga sa kanila?
I didn't ask them permission, but I told them plenty of times. Like, I actually said, like, oh, I'm going to try this, I want to do it. And it wasn't so much their approval, I wanted their support. And
then sabi nila,
they support me. First time I told my mom, she laughed at me.
Bakit?
Kasi she thought I was joking. Then yung second time, she got mad, saying, no, you're not going. Kasi she didn't want me to leave. And the third time, she considered it, she said, okay, as long as one of us goes with you, at least, you know, in first 2 weeks. And after that, they supported me throughout. So,
may kasama ka nung nag-move ka? At the beginning, sinong kasama?
Parents ko.
Parents.
But for 2 weeks lang.
For 2 weeks lang. But so you live alone here, yes, apart from the family. So how was it? It's been more than a year.
It's hard.
Alone.
It's hard because the holidays are coming up, and I don't know if I could go back home yet. And it's hard being away from them because I'm the only one here.
Napanood ko nga in one episode your mom ng music update. Yeah. Your mom called and napaiyak ka.
Yes. It's embarrassing, but that was real because I did not expect to hear my mom's voice. I haven't heard it for so long, and I rarely get to chat with her online, or so let alone talk to her on the phone. So it's very hard.
Yeah. Napanood ka sa Idol, di ba? As bandmate ni Sam.
Yeah, yeah.
Anong reaction ng parents mo nung you told them? And then they finally saw you on TV.
They're very supportive again. They tell me every time when there's like a story online about Idol, or they would they would tell all their coworkers to watch Idol, and then they're very supportive. Like,
you said na ang plan mo talaga was modeling and music performing. When Idol was offered to you, but okay, mas
okay, kasi
natapat ka.
Oo, kasi I'm not an actor talaga. But I guess the musical aspect of Idol was what drew us into audition. Kasi we thought it would be like it's gonna be like a musical, so it's not like a heavy teleserye. But then, of course, you know, there's a lot of acting, and I didn't expect to get into that. But it was a good experience. Like our manager said, at least you guys got to experience the hardest part of showbiz, like day in and out, no sleep, and crazy hours.
Was the Tagalog part one of the biggest challenges?
Super. Learning the lines was pretty hard. And minsan they would cut out my lines, but it was okay. It's a good experience. So.
Are you studying my Tagalog lessons or?
There is, in between other like workshops and lessons, yes, they.
But on your own, anong ginagawa mo din? Kasi
I watch a lot of ABS-CBN, and I have children books, and
kasi si Gerald, so then they read comics talaga.
Ah, yeah.
Like, mga ganun.
Pati si Sam, I ask him for advice too, kasi syempre I relate to him most because we're both from America, and I try to watch as many movies or the series or read the books or just ask my parents. They speak to me in Tagalog na.
Tagalog.
Kasi
at home ba?
My the rest of my relatives and my lola, they all speak Tagalog. It's just that our generation in the States, like all my siblings and my cousins, we're all Americanized talaga.
When you moved here and decided to pursue showbiz, do you have may idea ka ba regarding yung the cynicism about the Amboy coming back here and pursuing showbiz? Aware ka ba sa mga ganun?
Yeah.
Natakot ka ba?
Medyo.
Who is this Amboy?
Medyo. Kasi I wanted to get into this on my own terms. I don't want to like get into a show na bigla. Like I don't want them to think, oh, this person thinks you could get into showbiz. I wanted to take my time talaga. But it just so happened that everything rushed and like I'm getting all these projects, and yes, I was scared of what their reaction would be, but to clarify things, like my only intention for the first couple years was to model and sing and pursue that. Then if the time was right and if my Tagalog was better, I would pursue showbiz more, but everything's happening at once now.
What would Sam usually tell you regard, kasi pinagdaanan niya na yun, or ang mga advice niya sa inyo?
Na if I hear a word na I don't understand, to write in your phone and make your own dictionary. I got that from Sam. And then watch
regarding,
a lot of
regarding showbiz.
Ah, showbiz. Sam is very
the business going about.
Sam is very humble. He taught us he taught me like to be humble about everything and to always appreciate your the staff and the crew members and everyone, and even if you don't know them, kahit sino, you say hi and you greet them. And that was one of the most important things he taught me, like, because you're gonna be working with them for how many years, and you want to give respect, be respectful.
What other showbiz projects are you looking forward to? More acting? Or aside from this, meron bang ibang offer?
Yeah, there were other I don't know if I could see. There are other shows
acting
separate from 3AM that that requires acting then under ABS, but there's no final words on it, and some side modeling things too.
Sino mo mga showbiz crushes mo? You look forward to working with?
I've actually met a couple of them. Sila Casey, sila Bea. They're very mabayet and super super down to earth, and I fall for the nice kind of girl. And recently, sa idol, Sarah. In person, I find myself staring at her a lot, and she's very beautiful in person.
But ito na lang, parang question. How do you feel about you? What happened with idol? Parang, were you sad that it didn't
happen? Oh naman. Pero it was a good experience. This is our first show. We don't know how long shows usually last, so we thought it was normal. Like, oh, it's ending already. Okay, and we're just very blessed at the end, you know, because we didn't really expect to be part of a show, especially the band. We had just got our record label and we started recording, so this was just a plus, like, to another outlet for us to use our talent.
Right. So would you say that pursuing your career right now is your number one priority?
No.
Really? What is it?
My number one priority is to make a difference. I don't know how yet, but I want to not be successful in the way people would think, you know, with money or wealth. I want to be successful in a way that's that could benefit those who are in need. Say there's a lot of people that don't have a lot of things, or they can't experience the things that I'm doing, and if showbiz is a way to do that, then of course it's part of my priority na, you know, showbiz. So my priority is
humanitarian.
Yeah, it sounds corny, but I do want to give back. I do want to give back. Say when you're here, it's a different culture. It's a culture shock. You see people, like, it's normal to live on the street, and it's that. And hopefully, if given.
What particular charity kaya like ang gusto mong you wanna be involved with, like, for the children, for the disabled, healthcare, mga ganun?
If I thought about it, probably the children. They have their whole lives ahead of them, and if I can help any way, that would.
The reason I ask about your priorities, I want to ask if there's a girlfriend.
Hey, wala. Wala.
Wala lang.
Wala.
For how long have you been
single? Long time. I don't even remember.
Don't even remember. So doesn't bother you living.
Hello.
Living alone, being single, and having no girlfriend.
It's actually very I can concentrate more on myself and improve myself, and by doing that I can help others, and there's no distractions. Or,
but what if you find the right girl, if you have to choose between opportunities and true love?
I will find a way to balance it.
Thank you very much, guys. I'm Nap. Nap from ABS-CBN. Nap, as in N-A-P.
Ah, Nap.
Do you have pictures online na pwede mong gawin? Sa Cornerstone yata, medyo may pagka-religious. How do you feel about going sexy? Pag ganyan, if it's required. Kasi in modeling naman, wala naman masyado yun, diba?
Yeah. In terms of religion and going sexy, I think there's a tasteful way of doing it. Hindi masyado hubad. You could do it like how Sam does. He just wears pants, and it's tasteful. I don't know how to explain it. It doesn't look like I don't know the word. It doesn't look wrong.
How far have you gone sa modeling ba? Hanggang shorts ka lang?
Hindi. Shirtless.
Shirtless.
Mm. I've never done underwear.
Do you don't think you will do one? Or?
I don't think I would, but I can't say that I wouldn't. But I don't think I would because I'm not comfortable.
Not comfortable and scared with the family?
No, not. Just because I wouldn't. Maybe if their shorts were longer.
Longer.
Like board shorts. Yeah, maybe.
Yes, again.
Thank you very much, Kyle. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.